And in the beginning, it's just a case of finding the balance. And like with everything, practice, practice, practice. So we come into the Fodhavee, and we're going to explore something called the tree hugger. So we take the hands onto the inside of the arms, and we reach the hands up and over to hold the back of the ribs. And here we can gently pull the armpits down to the ground as I pull and stretch my feet away from my head. So there's a slight bend in my knees, and I'm pulling my hands down as I gently press with my feet. From here you may want to interlace your hands and deepen the stretch. So she's getting this traction in the spine. I'm pulling my hands down and I'm pressing my feet away. From here you can also use your thumbs and just gently press into the back of the spine. Into the shoulder blades. It's kind of like I'm opening up the chest. And then you can gently come to hold onto the elbows and just gently release the shoulders. Center, change the fingers to the other side, and use the hand to support. So she's getting a nice side stretch. We come palm to palm, she releases the hands, and then I straighten my arms and bring them down. So it's tree hugger, bringing the hands in, using the hands to pull the ribs down, and then going with, we call this love mudra, so bringing the hands onto the elbows. Bringing the arms around, a couple of tractions here, side stretch.
It's very common for the flyer, when they are flying, especially the super yogi, which is this traction here, to lift the legs up. And that will make the movement not work very much, because then my base loses the support and the platform. So I really need to walk on my legs. Can you notice my toes are relaxed, my feet is relaxed, but there is some kind of engagement on my legs to keep the resistance here, so I give something for my base to push against. So as she tractions, I keep the resistance with my legs. So just to optimize the traction.
Okay. So another round with the same part.